Good evening and welcome to Seamus' Spire live here on the Isle of Skye this evening. Obviously, we realise there were a little technical difficulties here to start off with, but we are streaming live from the Isle of Skye. There is nothing that tells you that more than having a little technical difficulty to start with. The opening dance here, of course, was the Gay Gardens, and well done to Hamish, Napier and Seall for their wonderful dancing. Now, the Seall Festival has been running all week, and these incredible musicians behind us have been performing at various concerts throughout the week. But the concert sets are pushed to the side, and it's all about the Ceilidh this evening. And that's exactly what we all want you to do at home. Push the tables, push the chairs to the side, grab yourself that loved one, or someone you maybe want to throw around the house a bit more and take them up for a dance. Now, we've just had the Gay Gardens. Our next dance is going to be a dashing white sergeant. So we're going to hand it back to the band as you push, well, your table, your chairs, and your loved ones to the side.
I don't know about you guys at home, but I'm out of breath after that one. We are going to do a couple of numbers, performance numbers for you tonight, just to give you a rest. So for those of you that were dancing there, you can have a wee sit down. And Lauren and I are going to sing you a song called Fjurag Sifjur. Oh. I'm not used to playing so fast these days.
Gorgeous. We're just going to get a little chat with Lauren in a moment and Rachel. But yeah, as I say, we're looking at the numbers. We know you're tuning in from all across the globe, which is wonderful to see. Of course, head over to our social media channels, search for Seall Small Halls Festival. Leave your comments, ask if you've got questions for the guys or any of the crew or anyone here on the Isle of Skye. We'll do our very best to try and answer all your questions this evening. But I'm going to walk over here and get a little blether with the ladies just now. Rachel, tell us about that song that you just sang for us, please.
That was A Few Rugs, A Few, and it's... I think it's from Barra, that one. I suppose I should have sung a song from Skye, really, being here. But Puir is the Gaelic word for sister, for anyone that doesn't know. And in the song, the woman's singing to her sister, saying that she's, supposedly she's stuck on a fairy hill on Barra, and she's telling her sister about it.
What do you mean, supposedly? Everyone gets stuck in a fairy hill.
Well, I know. I mean, I believe
it's
it.
So natural. Lauren, obviously this year musically has been so difficult for everybody, really, but tell us what this week's been like for yourself to get out and actually get to play with your friends again.
Oh, well, yeah, it's been quite an emotional roller coaster, to be quite honest. I think we all came in with a little bit of kind of uncertainty as to how it would be, and just to be able to create music in such a safe space has been just a total joy. So, yeah, I think you can probably guess that by all our beaming, smiley faces.
It's so nice to see so many happy people in one room. Something that none of us have seen in quite a long time now. So, well, listen, we'll let you get set up for your next set.
Cheers,
we're going to let the ladies push their microphone to the side as a band have arranged a lovely set of Gaelic waltzes for us next. So, of course, at home, grab yourself that someone special and take them up on the floor for this one.
Thank you.
Barracker and Hetty's Falls, Margaret's Falls, and my Cape Breton home. And how about giving up once more for our dancers, Seall and Hamish Napier there, putting us through our paces. Quite a couple indeed. And of course, we are trying to adhere socially distancing. You can see that from all the band and of course for the dancers, which we have this huge big space that would usually be full of people having a great old night of it. And of course, behind that is the bar. Some of you may be hearing a noise that sounds like a lorry air brake going on, but that's just the smoke machine behind. So we have our own sound effects going on here as well. Now, our next piece and song comes from the 2008 BBC Radio Scotland Young Musician of the Year. He's now a dad, and he is married to the wonderful Megan Henderson, who is singing and on fiddle this evening. They have brought their very own little Joey Grace along as well, and I can tell you that she has lit up the room every single time our little six-month-year-old eyes and smile come in as well. But she's sleeping, unlike us. We're downstairs having a party, but while Ewan's tuning, I'm going to get a little blether with mummy Megan just now. Megan,
hello, Daddy.
Hello. Now, tell us, the wee ones had the week of her life, really. She's been up here, obviously cheering us all up. But here you are getting to perform this evening and having a great time of it. You know, as I asked the girls, what's it like to perform with your pals again?
Oh, it is so lovely in so many ways. But I think you can, with playing music, you kind of, sometimes you get caught up in it just kind of being your job and stuff. But then the other night we're having a lovely session and it was just having that kind of feeling of people around you, like just kind of getting a vibe, and all of a sudden it was this kind of magical thing was happening. It's just, it's really lovely. It's quite overwhelming.
Absolutely.
This week, honestly. We kind of feel like we've been like picked, like the lucky ones out of 2020. We've all been like put in this little place together. So yeah, feel very, very fortunate to have had this week. Just want to bottle up all this feeling.
You mentioned the words lucky and fortunate there. How lucky and fortunate do you feel to be back performing with your husband again?
That's all right. No, it's very nice to get to share this week together and working it all out with a wee six-month-old as well, who's been a wee star. So
yeah.
Just keep sleeping, Joey.
Just keep sleeping. She is a wee star indeed. Now, Ewan, we get to ask you the same question. Obviously, both perform with the multi-award-winning band Brebach, usually as your day-to-day job. Here you are in amongst your pals again and back playing with your wife in a different setup. I know what the answer you're going to say when I ask you what it's like, because, well, you'll get a slap if you don't give the right answer. But back playing with your pals again, back playing music, back doing what you do best.
Well, it's just amazing, really. I can't say anything more than has already been said, really. We feel very fortunate, and not just to be playing music, but to be involved in such an innovative project, you know, bringing people together. So we're very grateful to all of the hard work that's gone on behind the scenes, because there has been a huge amount of work that goes on behind the scenes to make this possible. So we're very grateful to everyone.
For sure. Now, you've got a song lined up for us just now, a Richard Thomson song.
Yeah, and I learnt this song. It's from my old friend who's sitting over here on the keyboard, Mr. Hamish Napier. So, yeah, he taught me this many years ago, and we've had a lot of fun singing it. So, yeah.
Good, we'll look forward to hearing that just now.
Sarah Molly to James, that's a fine motorbike. A girl could feel special on any such lake. Said James to Ren Molly, my hat's off to you. To Vincent Blacklight in 1952. And I've seen you on the corners and cafes, it seems. Red hair and black leather, favorite color scheme. And he pulled her on behind and down to Box Hill. They derive. St. James to Red Molly, here's a ring for your right hand.
Sergeant McCrae. They've taken young James A.D. for armed robbery. With a shotgun blast to his chest, left nothing in sight. Come down Red Molly to his dying bedside. And when she got to the hospital, there wasn't much left. He was running out of road, he was running out of breath. And he smiled to see her cry. He said, I'll give you. In this world, it's a fence and black lightning and a red-headed girl. 'Cause Nortons and Greaves and Indians and Harleys, they won't do. They don't have a soul like a Vincent 52. And he took her by the hand, he slipped her the keys. He said, I've gone no further. For these I see Indians and nails and leather and chrome, and they're swooping down from heaven to carry me home. And he gave her one last kiss and died. He said, I'll give you my Vincent.
Awesome, that from Richard Thompson's 1991 album Rumour and Sigh, Vincent Black Lightning. What a song indeed. Well, we're going to leave the singing to the side at this point, and we're going to get back to the dancing as we invite Seall Lee and Hamish back up on the dance floor, this time for a military two-step. Are you excited?
Oh, they're actually playing this one.
They're actually playing this one. I thought it was the second half before we introduced Megan Henderson and Ewan Robertson to the dance floor, but
it's our stunt
doubles. It's the stunt doubles are taken to the stage instead. So look at the smile. How excited do they look to be dancing along to this one? Ewan in his home village of Carrabridge is known as Twinkle Toes, and we're about to see why. So let's hand it over to the band and Ewan and Megan for this military two-step.
Just a wee spot of mic rejigging. I hope you're dancing at home, you folks at home. I'm going to sing a song now, which is going to finish off the first half. And it was written by the amazing Rick Taylor, who we lost last year, but he made his home on Skye, for he loved it so. And that's what this song tells us. One, two, a one, two, three, four.
Sky in My Heart by the wonderful Rick Taylor there. Well, that's us for the first half. We're going to let you go and put the kettle on, get yourself organised for the raffle. We have 10 incredible prizes. Before I do, though, a big thank you to Corey Campbell from Innocent Campbell Communications, who's at home picking up all your messages and passing them on this evening. So, in no particular order, a big hello to Sophie B from North Yorkshire, Scotty Fergus, Ontario in Canada, Catherine in Essex, Jackie in Neudert, Braise, we're getting close, Andrew in Derbyshire, David in Turriff, and Rob in York. Great to have your company this evening. We know there are many, many more of you. Do get in touch. Remember, you can ask a question, anything you fancy. But at this point, I'm going to welcome on Mary to talk about the Seall Festival this year. And of course, she has the big box with all your raffle tickets in it. I'm afraid it is too late to buy a raffle ticket now. The entry's closed at 9 o'clock. So we're going to welcome Mary over. Hello, hello. I'm going to get a microphone here. So I tell you what we're going to do is, while we let Mary settle into Lauren's microphone, we also have a sheet that I'm going to go and pick up just now, an A3 sheet that tells all about the prizes. So let's see what we have in store this evening. Thank you very much.
Gary, I think some of those are doubled up.
They're doubled up?
They're doubled up.
Oh, smashing.
No, so they shouldn't be doubled up.
Well, that's okay, we can manage. Mary, before we start doing the raffle, how has this year gone for you?
The whole year or just the last 10 days?
Let's talk about the last
long
ten, let's talk
year.
About the last 10 days because your first time steering the ship here and it's obviously been through troubled waters with COVID and everything.
A wee bit stormy.
Yes.
A wee bit choppy.
A wee bit choppy. Plenty of red diesel although, it was fine. The engines kept going.
Yeah, just. I think we're kind of getting over the top of the wave now and kind of, you know. So yeah, it's been a funny old year, but as it has for everybody. And I think we're kind of navigating our way out of the stormy patches and into some calmer seas.
Absolutely.
Which is quite exciting and kind of, this has been amazing. This was the wee lighthouse at the bottom of the kind of horizon that kept us going all year. And just really happy it's gone so well. It's just been quite an amazing experience. I can't, just makes me all emotional.
Well, there is no question yourself and the team have done an incredible job, especially through really difficult circumstances.
Yeah, we've got an amazing wee team. We've got Ruari, obviously, here on sound. And I have to make a special mention for Sarah, because we never really see Sarah, do we? But she's always there, working away at home on her computer, making it all happen. So it's been amazing. So, yeah, and Rosie's manning. She keeps texting me and telling me when there's a lag and things. So that's great.
Thank you,
and
I'm Rosie. Kinda
like, mm-hmm. And Ishbel, who's been organising all the workshops and everything. So, yeah, great wee team. And couldn't have done any of this without them. So, yeah, it's been really special. And these guys are just...
They're not
Words
bad.
Fail me.
They're
Words
not bad, that's for sure.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, we must also thank everybody who's donated a prize this evening because the prizes have been terrific.
They're really great, yes. Uh-huh. I've got my eye on that one, but I wasn't allowed to buy any tickets. So.
that one in particular is the Isle of Harris Distillery Gin gift hamper.
Yeah, that would have gone down really well.
Well, it might yet because lots of the band have actually bought tickets, so we may get to experience it this evening, who knows.
So will we go around and get band members to choose a raffle ticket, or do you think there's a bias in there?
Well, it really depends if they pick their own ticket out or not, so let's find out.
I know, let's see.
How would you like to start? Would you like to start with the Isle of Harris Distillery Gin? Because it's number one in the list.
Okay, let's just do that.
Okay.
Let's do
Good
it.
Good luck, everybody. What's going to happen is your name is on a ticket and your number, so hopefully we should be able to read out your number and your name. So,
But Gary, I don't think I've got my specs on, have I? Are they on my head? No.
No, they're not there.
No, I can't read. I'm lost without my specs. What am I going to do?
There we are.
Thank you so much.
We need those.
Yeah. Okay. Right. Well, we might as well just go round and order of the band.
Absolutely. So once again, for the Isle of Harris Distillery Gin Gift Hamper.
Oh, Christine Davis, all the way from Armadale Castle and Gardens.
Well done,
well
Christine
done,
Davis.
Christine. She'll be delighted.
Terrific.
I know. I'm going to visit Christine next week.
I think
we're all
going to visit
come
her.
And see you, Christine.
Get the kettle on, Christine. We won't be far away. Okay, the next prize is books with Scottish theme. Malin Makes Music, and that's an Archive of Happiness and a Scots Dictionary of Nature from Amanda Thomson.
Okay, this, I do not know this person, so this must be somebody, it could be somebody miles away. So this is Miss Allen, and it's ticket number, can't read, L4NYKW.
That's the registration plate for the car parked outside.
It is.
Well done. Yeah, that's great. We'll sit that with that one.
We should add as well that Maggie or someone from the festival will be in touch with you. So don't worry, they will get in touch with you after to help you get your prize because they're coming straight from the distributors out to their homes. We don't actually have them here this evening. Okay, the next prize is a virtual whiskey tasting. I guess last night you was on a virtual whiskey tour with five different drams last night, which was amazing. So, help me.
So this one, now I think if I remember rightly, this is Lisa Graves, and it's GHP8BA. And I think that Lisa and her partner, Anthony, come to the small halls every year from Cornwall. I think I'm right. And so that's really lovely to see that they've won a prize. Excellent.
My microphone apparently is gone, so there we go. Thank you.
We're really good at this, Gary. Well, we could be a double act.
When it works, we're on it. Hello and welcome to Take the Floor with Mary here, who's leading the band. A little bit of microphone technology problems here, but well done. The virtual whisky tasting, you're in for a real treat there. Now, there's that one of those doublers we're talking about. Okay, let's move on with the Small Halls Musicians CD stack. Oh, ho, ho.
Oh, ho.
Now, that consists, I assume, of CDs from the musicians all here this evening as I turn round and nobody nods their head. They do not know about this prize, so this is going to be interesting. So the lucky winner is?
So this is Tanya Ashton-Jones, who lives down in Slate as well, and her number is UF7VEK. Congratulations, Tanya.
Well done indeed, and well done to all the musicians who have made an album that are donating this evening. Good luck, guys, hunting about for that one. Okay, this one caught my eye earlier. It's a beautiful Edinbane Pottery Ebb and Flow mug. So someone's in for a special one for Christmas for this one. You really can't beat a raffle, can you, for suspense?
Oh my goodness, this is Tanya Ashton-Jones as well.
Fix. Well done, Tanya. Two prizes coming your way. That's that lovely Edinbane Pottery Ebb and Flow mug. There we go.
That we all had our eye on.
That we all had our eye on, yes. Now, this next one is from Skye Skins. It's a mimosa skin. It looks absolutely gorgeous. I'm not quite sure if you can catch it with the light on the camera, but it looks like a big, massive bear, and it looks very, very warm. No animals were shot or harmed in the making of this mimosa skin, we can add. And the winner?
And the winner is Katrina Logan, and it's FB7UGD.
Well done, Katrina. Big mimosa skin from Skye Skins coming your way. Okay, now we're getting into some serious prizes here. This one's from the distillery. It's whisky-themed gift hamper from Torrevig. Now, it's basically full of whisky memorabilia. We've got hip flasks, we've got whisky tokens and things, but we can't actually put a bottle of whisky in because some countries don't accept whisky through their imports. So, a great prize, but I'm afraid you are going to have to add your own whisky. Good luck with that. But the winner
is Anne McCaskill.
Well done, Anne McCaskill.
And the ticket number is AHRBHV.
Very good. Well done once again, Anne. Now we move on to the South Skye Sea Kayak Taster Session. Unfortunately, we can't send kayaks all over the world because of import tax. So once again, you have to bring your own kayak if you live in Barbados, unless you come and visit us in the Isle of Skye, of course. And the winner of that one, who's going to pick the lucky winner for this one? It's Lauren MacColl.
And this is Liz Phillips. And the ticket number is H8WGJL. And Liz is in Breckish.
Well done, Liz.
And she's Rosie's mum.
There you go.
Who's like texting me to say when there's a lag.
Well, hopefully that'll cheer you up, Rosie. There we go. Well done. And as we are here in the Sligachan Hotel this evening, they have kindly donated a one-night bed and breakfast for two, and this is the last prize of the evening. We can tell you, if you've never visited here, you're in for a real, real treat. We're here in Seamus's Bar this evening, but the hotel next door and the apartments and everything are quite amazing. And once again, a huge thanks to all the staff for looking after us and catering for us for the last few days. They've been absolutely incredible. So a big, big prize, Mari.
I'm a bit scared to say it. This is like a fix again.
Go on.
Is Christine Davis again from Armadale Castle.
Well. Christine Davis. Well, we just redraw it.
No, she's not here to authorise that. That's not fair.
There we go.
Well done, Christine.
Yes, well done, Christine. Well done, one and all. Excellent stuff. And thank you very much to everybody who did donate to the raffle and, of course, to everybody who passed on their prizes. Now, I'm going to pass over and have a wee blether with Inge Thomson here. Hello, hello.
Hi, Gary. How's it going?
Great. Now, that last song you sang, the Rick Taylor, we've got another Rick Taylor song coming up, but a very, very special song and a song that was certainly dear to your own heart.
Yes. Well, Rick, he was a big star, really, going back in through the 70s and the 80s. He made horn arrangements and played on loads and loads of people, household names, albums. But then I guess the sort of the touring and the fast life had become enough, so he decided to move to Skye and make Skye his home. And I think he'd planned to sort of stop, to have like a nice, quiet, sort of semi-retired life, but he got really embroiled with the Scottish folk scene, which is how we all came to know him and came to love him. And he was just the most generous spirit when it came to his own knowledge. And I think, although obviously he's not here, but we all still feel him in our playing. Everybody that learned anything from him still feels him in their playing, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, we had a wee chat last night and we were talking about the first gig since January and getting to perform in Dunvegan Castle in such a stunning setting as well. Here we are, another stunning setting with the full, your band and the other group that were performing for the different concerts all together. And, you know, again, I suppose it's one of those questions that we're going to keep asking people probably for the next year about what it's like to perform live again. But, you know, for each person, it's so different. So tell us what it's like for yourself to be back performing again.
Well, it is amazing, but I have to say there was some fear and trepidation before coming up here. Just, can I still do this? I don't really know, but certainly the spirit and the momentum of this has been carrying, certainly me, and I think probably everybody through this week, because it feels like there's, you know, a spark of hope, because we've all been so so solitary, you know, in terms of our sort of playing music, apart from doing things over Zoom and things like that. That it feels like we've turned a corner and there's a wee kind of, that's the wee, the, like Mari was saying, the lighthouse, there's a wee spark of hope. So, yeah, I think there'll be more things like this happening. And I think, you know, in another year, it'll be a distant memory, you know, of lockdowns and such like. So.
Hear, hear to that. Yeah, I think as musicians and performers, we're kind of getting used to performing at kind of events like this and then stopping and there's no applause. We know there are people at home appreciating the music all over the world, tuning in and absolutely loving the music and the hard work that everybody's performing and doing. But my goodness, that feeling it's going to be again when we actually finish a set and stop and there's a round of applause, a real round of applause. It's going to be pretty special.
It will be special, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much. I'm going to let the band start off the second half now. I'm going to hand Hamish's microphone back. We're going to go and try and fix this one on my lapel and see how we get on. But once again, please give a big round of applause wherever you are tuned in this evening to our incredible house band, to Mari and all the staff here at the Seall Festival. Back to the band. Thank you.
Hello. So I'm Sua, and I'm actually going to switch over to another instrument just now. And what we're going to play for you is actually, it was a birthday card gift present for a big birthday I had this summer. And it was given to me by Hamish's mother. She painted this incredible card of a scene out of, well, it's the scene from the bottom of the garden in the woods. And it's also, it's like a trifold card. And when you open it out, it's got a scene from a sort of stylized Korean painting. And in the middle of it was this thing called Saw Pop for Sua. And it's a lovely tune that she composed for my birthday. So we're going to play that for you now. Thank you, Mary Louise.
So this is a real saw. You can actually, you'd be glad to know that Sua didn't cut the tree down at the end of the garden. It's still standing. But she has used the saw on stage before. We had a concert at the Edinburgh Festival where you had to play the saw and then cut the leg off a chair after playing. But don't worry, we won't be doing that here.
Actually, it was a chair that I was sitting on, so I subsequently fell off it.
Absolutely stunning. Now, I'm going to get a little blether with Sua here and Hamish because, well, recently you got engaged and congratulations to you both. A big round of applause, I think, from everybody, yes. And in true Highland fashion, it was Sua who actually asked Hamish to marry her, which is just terrific. Now, having spent the last few days up here in Skye, you've also been exploring some other new places, and you've also potentially looking here at a venue for next year because it's just so beautiful up in this neck of the woods.
Absolutely.
Yeah. What is it about Skye, and in particular this area, that just makes you think this is the spot?
Oh my goodness, there's it's countless reasons to be here. I've been coming to Skye and the Sligachan for many years. I remember a night, well, it was a stay here in about 1995, where I came and did some hill walking with some friends from Fockabers. And I've also climbed all the Coolin Hills, but yeah, all the Munros in Skye as well. But we had the first extended stay here this time last year for our first small halls tour here together. And a year ago, and we were absolutely sold. Deirdre, who's been looking after us, and the whole team here have been absolutely incredible. So it's a no-brainer, really.
Yeah, absolutely. Hamish, do you ever worry that you might wake up and Sue is maybe trying to chop your leg or take a couple inches off it with the saw?
I actually was moving it the other day there and I nearly cut myself on it, so it's a bit of a health and safety hazard, isn't it?
Well, obviously, we do wish you a lifetime full of health, happiness and no sawn off limbs, of course. But next up, we've got the Highland Scottish. And what, Hamish, you're a good man for the tunes. What tunes have you got arranged for this Highland Scottish?
Well, you're actually asking the wrong person.
Sue, get that saw. Get that saw.
What have we got for this one?
I tell you what, we've got three Strathspeys, but we're playing one of my very favourite Strathspeys, which comes from the Black Isle, and it's called Munlochy Bridge.
Munlochy Bridge, terrific. Okay, we'll hand it back to the guys, and hopefully we might have some batteries ready for the microphone next time as well.
So we're going to continue with, as I said before, another one of Rick's works. And these are Rick's song words, which he put to a very well-known tune by Scott Skinner. And this is Hector the Hero.
Thank you. I'm lonely and need to return. All the ghosts in my blood, they are calling me now, but I won't take the
dry eye in the house. My goodness, Kleenex will be doing a rare old trade after that one for sure. That was Hector the Hero, and many of you who visited Scotland before will also have seen the statue of Hector the Hero, Hector MacDonald, up in Dingwall in the Highlands of Scotland, so be sure to check that out. We're going to pass it on, we're going to keep the songs going this time, we're going to pass over to Sean Gray. And Sean, tell us what you're going to sing for us, please.
Well, I'm going to sing a song that started off as a poem. It was written by a fantastic poet from Ayrshire, a man called Rab Wilson. And it's a poem called Ghosts, and I put it to music during lockdown. And it tells a story of a village that used to be called Ben Huat. It existed initially to mine iron ore and then to mine coal. And when the coal mining left, so did the village. So it just talks about what was there and the memories.
Now, we have to say that your shirt has got a lot of love online this evening. we're happy to say. Can you tell the good folks who are watching across the world where you purchased your garment?
Well, I get all my stuff custom made, of course.
It's an absolute cracker. As I say, he's not giving much away, I'm afraid. You're just going to have to keep looking at the pattern and searching online for that. But while we let people go and hunt across the internet, Sean, we'll let you continue with this lovely song.
Folk music works for me.
Outside stood Ben Paul, where openest men in smite the iron stain. The light ran out and then they might far go, and seen through the hex it's like some Machu Picchu, and weird plateaus and mines that find that grun. Streams, promontories, grass, their newbie are slowly heans back what are in. The mammoth open cast, the spoil heaps open, what a shelter things. And one cast beside some giant moody hill, that in brag what he seems the skill. I stood till after we the block of clay. Thank you.
can release what I esteem. The tattered remnants of a poppy reed. There's nae in here now, nae in here but
guests there, his very own words along to that great poem and arrangements. Now, the one man we've not had a blether with yet is Pipe Major Angus MacKenzie this evening. Good evening, Angus. Welcome to the party.
Yes, I'm a little bit late as usual.
Now, Angus, you've been living in Skye for a good number of years. What's it like to welcome your pals to what essentially is your home island, your family island now?
It's been great, actually. There was a point, I think, last night where kind of forgot about everything else that's happening in the world, and it felt quite normal, which is, I thought, was great, you know,
yeah,
that we're just kind of in this wee bubble and we can forget about other things. So, yeah,
absolutely, yeah. Now, at this point, I suppose we're kind of, for some areas, we're coming out the back of COVID with the tier system we have in Scotland. Others that are watching this evening around the world are in different tier systems from different places. But what was it like in the Isle of Skye during lockdown? Because, you know, we've had a conversation about this, but for everyone else at home, waking up each day and going out for a swim in the sea and playing with the kids and everything, it sounds pretty much idyllic, really.
I feel kind of bad about that in a way. It was magic. There was no cars on the roads. We could cycle everywhere we wanted to cycle. And yeah, in the sea quite a lot. It was tricky, but it was, you know, we made the best of the situation, which, you know, not normally in Skye do we get weather like we had during lockdown, so they couldn't have timed the weather better, really.
Better.
So, thanks.
Now, we've got a set of Gaelic waltzes lined up for us now. Gaelic waltzes aren't always best suited on the small pipes or the great Highland pipes, so you've got your whistle for this one.
I've got my whistle, and I've got my trusty leader in behind me. Megan's going to sing a Gaelic song called Hurma Hurry Har Gunai.
Well, we'll hand it over to the wonderful Megan Henderson for this one.
Hurma Hurry Yeah.
Thank you. Just an absolute stunner of a Gaelic song. Well, I'm afraid we are starting to come to the end of our big party live here from Seamus's Bar in the Isle of Skye. Thank you once again for joining us. It really has been so nice to have your pleasure all across the world. Well done once again to all the raffle winners as well. We will be in touch with your prizes. But we're going to finish off in true Highland style with, of course, a strip the willow. So, aike va from us. Good night, and we'll see you all again very soon. Cheers. The best goddamn Ceilidh man you've ever heard. Ladies and gentlemen, what an incredible night. If you'd like this band to play at your wedding or function next year, get in touch at seall.co.uk. In all seriousness, thank you so much for joining us. It really has been such a special night. 2020 has been a really difficult year for most, especially for musicians and people in the arts, and of course, you know, in many different work and genres across the world. But with your support, buying tickets, tuning in, this is as best as it can be just now. And thank you for dipping into your pocket and being part of, I say, an event like this and special occasions. Before we go, have to do a few thank yous to Deirdre and Gary here at the Sligachan Hotel. If you've never been, you must come and check it out. It really is an absolute, you know, it's a gem, a wee goldmine here in the Isle of Skye. Claire for all the amazing food and looking after us. We are getting bigger by the day. Thanks very much, Claire, I think. All the fundraisers who, of course, without this, it just wouldn't be possible. To Danny and Sandy, Archie and Alistair, Ruari on sound, all just done such a terrific job looking after us with all the camera work and sound and all the visuals that you are seeing at home. Now, I must add very, very quickly, people do struggle sometimes with streaming. It's potentially through with your own internet connections and things at home as well. We are in the Isle of Skye, so thank you so much for being patient with us as well. We're doing our very best to get it to you, and we hope that you've enjoyed the experience watching it all this evening. Sarah, who's at home looking after us and all the online content, of course, to Innes & Campbell Communications for all their online support throughout the whole event and this evening. To Isabel Strachan for all her help with the all the workshops throughout the week as well, and to Aeneas for the whisky tasting last night. It was very special, and of course to Rosie. And all this wouldn't be possible without Mary and her committee as well. So a huge round of applause, please, from everybody here for the wonderful Mary, for all her incredible hard work in pulling all this together. Well, well done. Once again, let's keep the thanks going at home for our incredible musicians. You've enjoyed them, you've heard them, you've sang with them, you've hopefully laughed, cried, and even danced with them. So from left to right, the wonderful Hamish Napier, Seall, Sean Gray, Ewan Robertson, Pipe Major Angus MacKenzie, Megan Henderson, Inge Thomson, Rachel Newton, and Lauren MacCalll. Of course, we can't all head off without one final kind of farewell and soiree. So we'll hand it back to the band. Take care of yourself, look after yourselves, have a wonderful Christmas, New Year, and we look forward to welcoming you back to another Seall event next year. Until then, take care. Bye bye.
Should all acquaintance be forgot and now?